this is Trentemøller and this is Records in My Life. Yeah, now we are touring with my new album. It's called Fixion. We have a new single out with Jenny Beth from Savages on vocals. And we are touring in the US and Canada right now.
So thank you very much for being on the show. I appreciate your time. I know you're a busy fellow. Let's change it up a little bit and start with an album that you've been looking for a long time for your collection, which...
Yeah. Yeah, actually, I've been looking for a vinyl edition of a classical album. It's with a piano player, Glenn Gould.
Right.
And he's doing these Bach pieces that I've been looking for quite a long time. And there are two different recordings. One he did in the 50s and one he did in the late 80s, I think it is. And I'm looking for the one that he did in the late 80s.
Because there was one that came out that was, maybe it's, I'm not thinking about the same one, and he was Canadian, by the way, just okay. Since we're in Canada, I thought we'd
yeah.
throw that in there.
Yeah, but, yeah. Okay, yeah.
But that's the Bach Variations? At
yeah,
the,
yeah, it is, yeah.
They released it on CD, right? But they just didn't
yeah,
release
yeah,
it on vinyl?
Yeah, they have been released on CD, and they are also on vinyl, but they are pretty hard to find, and I didn't want to buy a vintage vinyl. I wanted to buy a new vinyl, but I found it. Now on the internet, so
right.
I just have to buy it now. But it's something that I've been looking for some years now, actually.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Okay. On that note, too, give us an album which you think everyone should have in their collection. It should be a staple.
Yeah. For me, one of my favorite albums that I think everyone should listen to, actually, it's a Swedish album. That's called Jazz på Svenska. It's a jazz album that is made by the Swedish jazz pianist Jan Johansson. He died in the late 70s, but he recorded this fantastic jazz album where he played old Swedish folk songs in a very jazzy way, and it's a fantastic, very very. Beautiful album. It's only piano, upright bass. There are no drums, and then his way of playing these old Swedish Scandinavian folk songs. And I think even if you're not from Scandinavia, you can really find the beauty in those songs. And they sound so fresh and modern, even if some of the songs are more than 1,000 years old, I think, because it's really old folk songs from many years ago.
It's incredible. Is it? Can we find the album in North America?
Yeah. I think that I actually saw it last time we played in San Francisco. I saw it in a record shop because it's now a collector's item because it's such a beautiful album, and I also think that it recently also got released again.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Nice. Is there a record that you would, you know, we live in turbulent times right now, so is there an album you could recommend to us that would kind of bring a bit of world peace and a bit of tranquility to the people?
Yeah, and that it is funny because now I'm actually only mentioning piano albums, and that was actually not what I was thinking about. But I will definitely say there's a piano player that has recorded some Eric Satie. It's again a classical composer from France. He did some fantastic, very modern sounding like pieces, very minimal. And the piano player is called Pascal Roge, and he did some fantastic recordings of Eric Satie and his stuff. And it's so blissful and really, really, you kind of really relax and take time to think about your life. I think when you're listening to, you know, these albums, they're also out on vinyls, and also, yeah, I would say XRT, Pascal Roge recordings.
Good to me.
Yeah.
So is there an album when you were a young lad that inspired you to play music that really changed your life?
Yeah, definitely. It's it will definitely be Velvet Underground and Nico, that album that just did it for me.
Nice.
I can remember I was maybe 11 years old or 12 years old when I heard it the first time, and it was just playing in the radio. And normally I was just listening to what was the radio. My parents didn't really listen that much to, you know, music, and suddenly this song Venus in First came out of the speakers, and I was really blown away, and I was also a little bit scared because it sounded so different from what I normally heard. So I in the beginning thought it was a very scary track because I couldn't really understand it, but I was also really much fascinated by it, and this drone violin and Lou Reed's voice and the whole sound was really something that was so different. So I actually bought that on cassette because that was the medium back then, so that is definitely an album that changed my whole idea of how music could sound.
Yeah. Let's do a fun one. We'll end it on a fun one. Give us a recommendation for a nice romantic album.
Yeah, that's pretty hard, because I'm normally, if I'm thinking about romantic music, it's more like one song here and there.
Right.
But to pick out a whole album, I actually think this Miles Davis Sketches of Spain, isn't it called that? Yeah. That is quite romantic in its own way.
Right.
It's a fantastic album, and I think that I have used that sometimes back in when I was a teenager, and
you
I had a girl
a
in
smile,
there.
Nice.
Yeah, putting that Miles Davis album on, and that's always worked.
Terrific. Thanks so much for being on the show. And do you have any final words or messages to the World Wide Webs?
Just enjoy music, and that's what keeping me alive, I think. So, yeah. Salute to the music.
Perfect. Thanks again. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
If you like what you saw, check out more episodes and subscribe.